Hello and welcome to Masala Trails with me, Smita Deo. When you're in Maharashtra and you decide to go for a lovely traditional breakfast in a local eatery, the misal pav is always on their menu. Basically, the misal pav is a scrumptious cocktail of savory and sprouts. Here, the wholesome sprouts are cooked in a tangy tomato and a pungent onion gravy with garam masalas. That's not all. This delicious curry is enhanced further with a crispy farsan and some warm ladi pav, which when dunked into this curry and eaten tastes divine. Come, let's cook this beautiful dish and relish it. I've got all my ingredients ready. I'm going to heat a kadai first and heat some oil in it. I've taken about 3 tablespoons of oil. I'm going to add my onions immediately into this and I want them to bloom beautifully and then immediately add the rest of the masalas. So first let me add the onions, about 2 medium-sized onions. To this I'm going to add ginger, garlic and coriander paste, about a tablespoon and a half. Mix it really well. Immediately add red chili powder, about 2 tablespoons, a little turmeric powder. I've got some traditional Maharashtrian goda masala, which I'm going to add to this, a tablespoon and a half. A little bit of garam masala, about a teaspoon. And I'm going to saute this mixture really well. And then what I have done is, I had soaked about 2 cups of moth beans or matki overnight and then I had left it to sprout. Then in the morning what I did was, I just pressure cooked it with little bit of salt. So I'm going to add this to my masala that has been nicely fried. Mix this really well. To this moth bean curry, I'm going to add little water and some salt. A cup and a half of water is enough. And now we'll add some salt. Mix this well and cover it and cook it. While our usal is getting cooked for about 2 to 3 minutes, the exciting part of this dish is what we need to cook right now. It is a curd. The curd is basically a thin, watery, spicy curry that we have to add in our misal along with our farsan and onions and lime and coriander just before serving. So let's get the curd cooking. For the curd, I've taken about 1/2 cup of dry coconut grated, which I'm going to dry roast. This is nice and golden. I'm going to remove it in my mixer. In the same kadai, I'm going to saute onions that I have sliced, about 2 onions. I'm going to roast this nice and golden. I'll add some oil to this. Let's just check on the matki, the moth beans. The curry has been bubbling well, heated up nice. So let's shut the flame. Our onions are ready. And I'm going to grind the dry coconut that we have dry roasted and the onions into a fine paste. I add a little water to make this a nice fine paste. Our dry coconut and onion paste is ready. Now what I'm going to do is heat some oil in the kadai. Let's add our onions, finely chopped onions, about 2 medium sized onions. Saute quickly for about a few seconds and add the ginger, garlic and coriander paste, chili powder. I'm going to make this a little spicy, so I'm going to add about 2 to 2.5 teaspoons of chili powder, some turmeric, goda masala, some garam masala. Saute this for a few seconds. After you saute this masala for a few seconds, add 1 medium tomato finely chopped. Go on sauteing this masala till it leaves oil. My masala has started to leave oil, so we need to add the other ingredients. I've chopped 2 small potatoes finely, say about 1 centimeter in size, which I'm going to add to the masala. Mix this well. Our dry coconut and onion masala that we have made . Just saute this again for about a minute or so. And now you need to add loads of water, about a liter and a half. Salt. Mix this well and cover it. Let's check if our potatoes are cooked. Yes, our curd is ready and it's time to plate our dish. I've already got 2 ladi paos here. I'm going to make the misal in the bowl. For that, take about 2 spoonfuls of the moth bean curry. Add some curd to this. Serve some curd separately in a small bowl if anybody wants some extra spice to their misal. Sprinkle the crispy farsan over it, little onions, some coriander. Serve some extra kandas because some people do like that little crispiness from the onions also, with a wedge of lime, and your misal pav is ready to be relished. Do try this recipe at home and let me know if you liked it. Leave your comments in the comments section. See you soon. Bye.